Hi, I'm Dottie Metcalf-Lindenberger, a NASA astronaut and a graduate of Fort Collins High School in Fort Collins, Colorado. I can't tell you that I definitely knew back in high school that I'd be an astronaut someday, but I can tell you that it would not have been possible without solid skills in science, technology, engineering, and math. So if you're a student, take it from me. Education is the ticket to an incredible future. What you learn today can help you reach for the stars tomorrow.
Good morning for Dottie.
Good morning, Megan, and I'd like to say thank you to my parents who gave me such an appreciation for math and science and helped make sure that I got to see what Galileo taught us to look up at. So I just want to say thank you to them, and then also to my two very good friends, Danielle and Rochelle. We've been to a lot of good concerts together, huh?
View back inside the Quest airlock, where you can see that the spacewalkers are making steady progress already in their spacesuits.
And Houston airlock, we're completing EVA prep, picking up on step one of EMU purge.
And airlock Houston, we copy. We're following you to 1.220 EMU purge.
The EMU purge section of the preparations for today's spacewalk is where the cabin air is pushed out of the spacesuits. That process takes about 8 minutes, but there will be a pause at the 5-minute mark to bring the Quest airlock back up to 14.7 pounds per square inch that the rest of the station stays at. Once the hatch is open between the airlock and the rest of the station, the two spacewalkers will be moving into the crew lock portion of the Quest airlock and getting ready to close the hatch there so that it can begin being depressurized. Flight engineer Tracy Caldwell Dyson and mission pilot Jim Dutton working to get the SAFER installed on the Strachio spacesuit. That again is a simplified aid for EVA rescue, which would be used in the event that the crew became untethered from the space station and they needed to make their way back.
Guys, have a great time out there. Last EVA of the flight, and Dottie, we'll hand over to you.
Well, it's a beautiful day to go EVA. It's obviously you can see it's light outside, and I'll start you through these steps here.
Copy.
Mission Specialist Rick Mastracchio is going to be the first one to come out of the airlock today for the third and final spacewalk of the mission. He'll be moving right away to the S1 segment of the station's truss to finish the installation of the new ammonia tank assembly by connecting some fluid lines.
End up looking at M1, made it to M1. No FOD, the veil is back. There's no white line to speak of. And the deep end buzzing looks like it's up.
All right, this is nitrogen. So counter X5 loads and mate to QD.
Copy. So, Daddy, that handrail, is the inboard side of it or the outboard side of it, or does it matter?
Mastracchio here mating his first of the four fluid lines, this one a nitrogen line. There are two nitrogen lines and two ammonia lines to be connected.
I've got F2 in my hand, Daddy. I'm looking at M2.
F2 and M2 are good connectors.
Copy. Looking for FOD. No FOD. The no white line. The bail is back. The D10 button can be depressed.
Okay. Then counteract side loads and mate the QD.
Copy.
Mastracchio now has three of the four connections mated as the station and shuttle pass 216 miles above the tip of the Florida Peninsula in the city of Miami.
There you go. Now look over here. Oh, baby. You're going to want to take this one to the grandkids. All right. Get some work here, though. Get this baby.
Good view of the old ammonia tank assembly in motion on its way to the shuttle's cargo bay.
Flying over, Daddy?
We are going up over England, and then we'll be coming down over Eastern Europe.
Oh, it's a great pass. I guess that's Southern England or Ireland, maybe, we're hitting right now. All right, Clay. I've got the red on me, Daddy. Oh, I need to do a glove check. Stand by. Okay. There's an arm in the vicinity. I got a good eye on the robotic arm, Dottie.
Awesome, and it should be on the forward side of ESP2.
Well, yeah, it's kind of forward and nader.
Wow. Okay, I copy.
That's a spectacular pass over England. Dottie, looking at my gloves, they look good. I don't see anything.
And that's great news. Okay. Then if you'll get the daisy chain, you're going to pass that to Clay, and he's going to run it to the MMOD shield T-handle.
Okay, we think it's going to reach that far, okay. Well, you want me to start feeding it forward? Let me see how far I can get it, Clay, okay? See how it works, and then if it doesn't work, we'll have to have you get a little closer with it. Clay, your safety tether looks like it might be not tightening up there. Here, let me get a pull on it.
And Rick, I can also have you open the airlock thermal cover, too.
Yeah, I understand. That fixed it, Rick. Thank you. I think it may be caught on the other. Yeah, that's what it might be. Or might be out of slack. I don't know. That's a good idea. All right, Dad, I'm opening up the cover here.
Copy.
Anderson and Mr. Akio being careful to make sure everything is carefully tethered. They don't drop any of the things they'll be passing back and forth. Anderson is going to be passing the debris shields that he's removed from the external stowage platform over to Mr. Akio to be stored inside the airlock.
What do you think? Yeah, hold on. Might do it. Hold on, I got an idea. I'm gonna put it on the handrail right now.
Yeah. Or you want it down here? Where do you want it?
Well, just put it right here on the corner.
Okay.
And then when it comes by, we'll get it.
All right.
Okay, right there.
All right, let me get it to position.
Let's think this through very carefully before we move it.
Beneath the spacewalkers here, a view of the border between Germany and Austria from a distance of 218 miles. By the time the spacewalkers have gotten these debris shields stowed inside the airlock, the space station's robotic arm should be ready to pause in its journey to the shuttle's cargo bay. Give the crew members at the external stowage platform a chance to remove one of the handles.
Oh, Nelly.
Good view here of the debris shield that Anderson's removed from the external stowage platform, getting ready to hand that off to Mr. Akio for storage inside the Quest airlock. View here of Mission Specialist Clay Anderson near the center of the screen in the all-white spacesuit working at the external stowage platform number 2. And you can see at the bottom center of the screen the end effector, basically the hand of the space station's robotic arm with the ammonia tank assembly in its grasp. Crew members getting ready to remove on the other side of the ammonia tank assembly another handle that was used to keep it in storage on the mobile servicing system of the robotic arm. That's the rail cart that allows the arm to move up and down the station's truss segment.
My flaps are open.
All right, Clay, do the honors.
Okay, start heading to publish. You got good clearance.
Copy that. We're starting motion station aft.
Mission Specialist Stephanie Wilson and Pilot Jim Dutton moving the ammonia tank assembly in towards the external stowage platform to give the two spacewalkers access to the handle they'll be removing.
Good motion. Continue. Keep it coming.
Okay, copy. Good motion. And we're going to hand off the clearance of the tank and the AGB to ESP2.
Copy. What do you think? We got it. What do you think,
yep.
Rich?
Clearance looking at about 30 more to the publish, 30 more centers.
Yeah, you're going to have to turn the bolt, so whatever you're comfortable, Clay. Yeah, I'm going to go up to 60-80-12 up here. And... good clearance. Yep, good clearance.
Copy, good clearance, and steps ramping out. That's the publish.
Yeah, that looks good. Let me move to see if I can reach it okay, and then...
okay, go ahead and check it. Let us know when you're happy with it, and we'll get in standby.
All right. I'm going to give you this app. I got it. Hey, give me a couple seconds and I'll follow you down.
View here in Mission Specialist Clay Anderson's helmet camera of that handle that they just removed.
in your way a little bit.
All right.
Got to make sure the red doesn't get trapped, of course. There it is. Okay, it looks like it's good if you plug your end in. Okay, let me make sure the flaps are out of the way. The first one you can tuck behind a bag. The second one's a little different.
Yeah, they keep getting in the way, don't they?
Okay. Hold it while I push. Okay. Oh, my hand's in the way, sorry. Okay, give it a nice pushing in there. Okay, here we go.
All right, now I'll do it.
Hold on.
Here we go.
Dottie, the AGB is on. T-bar, T-handle's down, no. White line.
That is great news. It's good to have that AGB on the ESC2 there and not with us anymore.
Yep.
Both spacewalkers and the old ammonia tank assembly now on their way to the shuttle's cargo bay.
Around the seats first.
Right, that's what I did.
Okay.
On purpose.
All right.
So you're going to have to do a little maneuvering later on to get away on that.
Yeah.
Vision Specialist Clay Anderson is going to pause at the Harmony node on his way to the space shuttle to pick up a foot restraint that he's going to use in installing the old ammonia tank assembly into the shuttle's cargo bay. You hear inside the shuttle's cargo bay where Mission Specialist Rick Mastracchio has arrived, and as you can see, the old ammonia tank assembly on the end of the space station's robotic arm is not far.
And we are coming up right over Houston.
Oh, beautiful. Cool.
View here from Mission Specialist Clay Anderson's camera looking into the windows on the flight deck of the shuttle. Pausing for a photo, and now about to make his way down into the shuttle's cargo bay to meet Mission Specialist Rick Mastracchio at the other end of the lightweight mission peculiar equipment support structure carrier.
Hi, Rick. On my way back.
Copy. Take your time. I'm good.
We've got a heck of a view.
Fairly thin deck, by the way.
Copy.
I know you saw it, but good call, I guess.
Once the spacewalkers are done with the ammonia tank assembly portion of the evening, they'll be moving on to install a lightweight adapter plate assembly onto the end of the shuttle's cargo bay here. Both spacewalkers now in place. They're getting ready to receive that ammonia tank assembly. In the background, they're passing over France at a distance of 215 miles.
GCA, when you are, it's going to be about 2 meters to starboard and about a half a meter into the payload bay.
Rick, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, we're ready.
Okay, starting motion. Jeff is going to start with starboard motion first. Once we clear the sill, she'll start into the payload bay.
Good motion.
Good motion.
Okay, stop the end of the payload bay motion.
Okay, we'll stop into the payload bay. We'll continue to starboard.
All right.
We stop motion and let us know what you think. We can tweak it.
Well, it's very comfortable. It's a long way from the platform.
Hey, Clay, yeah, just make sure there's not any forces on your body when they release it.
No, I'm pretty relaxed.
Okay.
Your call, man.
All right.
Let's get a rep on it.
Okay, good call, Daddy. Thank you, Darby.
Once Mission Specialist Rick Mastracchio gets the final bolt tightened down on the Omonitek assembly, he'll be moving to the S1 segment of the truss, where the new Omonitek assembly is, to install the handle he's removing on that Omonitek assembly, while Mission Specialist Clay Anderson gets set up to ride the space station's robotic arm to the Columbus laboratory, where he'll be picking up a lightweight adapter plate assembly, which was used to attach experiments to the exterior of Columbus.
Hey, Daddy, I'm going to... Bolt 1 actually has a bunch of turns in it already, without the clevis.
I can see you turning it. Want to just go all the way to no white lines?
Nope. I don't think my hands can do that.
All right. Well, we won't make them tight.
Hey, I got a few turns in it, just to... The clevis rotated.
Well, we've got a good view of... Yeah, I think that's pretty... About as good as we're going to get.
Closer?
Not so much closer as a little bit further back and less pitch in your head, if possible. More
say that again. What do you want with pitch? Say it again.
No pitch. And more to your right. Perfect. Perfect. Stay there.
Mission Specialist Rick Mastracchio having a problem with the final bolt on the ammonia tank assembly, getting it aligned and to a place where he can drive it as the instructions call for. Team on the ground is thinking about the best way to get that bolt into place.
And Donnie, what's the plan? Is it to let Clay do like a turn or two and then let me try, or pop it up all the way?
No, he's going to completely back out bolt 3 and then have you try.
Okay.
A few here through Mission Specialist Clay Anderson's helmet camera as he prepares to loosen the bolt number 3 that he installed earlier. This hopefully will allow the spacewalkers to align the ammonia tank assembly in such a way that the bolt number 1 can go in.
Daddy, I'm going to rev the ratchet to the LMC right here. Hold on, Clay. I've got it. I think I was able to get the tank. I'm driving Alpha 7 now. Good news. All right, it's in. No white lines. We 16 turns, 9.2 foot-pounds green light. The tank was able to overcome by moving the tank around. That was a good call on bolt 3.
Great job, team. And Houston, copy, think it goes. Excellent work.
Wow. Just got to love ammonia tanks. Sun lost. There you go.
Here you go.
All right, it's locked. Nope, not there. Now it's locked.
Yeah.
All right, here we go. Try that. Turn one more time. Alpha 7, clockwise 2, checked. There we go. All right, Daddy. Let's see. Maybe... 0.6, half, so a little more than half a turn. Green light, 9.2 foot-pounds. Oh, it's got a lock.
Now I can finally say, good job, we have the ammonia tank in the payload bay. Nice job, you guys, especially the teamwork.
All four bolts of the ammonia tank assembly now installed, and the tank now safely in the shuttle's cargo bay, ready for return home.
Discovery Station, big loop for EVA and robotics.
Go ahead, Stan.
Okay, after thinking hard about this, we've decided that we are not comfortable beginning to pursue the LWAPA task this late in the day, especially given that we must get the arm deconfigured in order to get the MPLM back in the payload bay. So we would like to have Rick head off to FGB install, as we said earlier. For Clay, we'd like him to go ahead and drop off the APFR in Node 2 WIF 7, and we're working on further words for his tasking.
Okay. I copy that.
Scotty. We're reassessing the PET here, and we've got a new plan for Clay when you're ready to copy.
Okay.
Then I'm ready to copy.
All right. When he's complete with the ATFR relocate, we don't think that time is going to allow the P1 radiator task anymore. So we'd like to go ahead and defer that and instead ask Clay to go do the tool relocate task on page 7-130, and that's just at the airlock toolbox.
Okay, we copy, and that's not a problem. We can go do those tool relocates.
View here of the connections that Mission Specialist Rick Mastracchio is working with on the in preparation for the spare space-to-ground antenna that will be coming up on the next shuttle mission, STS-132.
I saw Rick.
Okay, that's connected.
I see it.
You guys are going to have to take us out for space or something, huh? Something. All right, Danny. I'll go put this cap on, and then I think I'm done with that part. Hey, Daddy, back at the airlock?
All right, Clay, we see you there at the airlock, and now you get that tool relocate bag. And just bring it over to the forward side, and we'll start unloading it.
Okay. All right. So let's see. Do I have everything? So, Dottie, in this bag now, there's a BR, one of the long screwdriver things.
Yeah, the BRS tool.
I guess that's what it's called. The vice grips, the T-handle, and the pin straightener.
Yeah, so those are, I understand, are coming back inside.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, let's also make sure you've got two adjustables on the negative, one adjustable on the outside.
Yes, ma'am, that's true.
Okay, Clay, I think we can open the airlock thermal cover.
I agree.
6 hours into today's 6.5-hour spacewalk, Mission Specialist Clay Anderson moving back into the airlock. Having finished up his last task for the day, dropping off some tools inside the airlock toolbox for use in a future spacewalk.
Yeah, let's get that bag back in.
Mission Specialist Rick Strachios still on the Z1 section of the truss, finishing up his work at the future home of the space-to-ground spare space-to-ground antenna coming up on the next mission, getting some cables bundled to clean up that area.
All right. Very good job to the conclusion of EVA-3. It's been awesome working with you guys. This is a really nice job, and Stephanie and Jim also with all their robotics. So,
Okay, Dottie. Well, thanks, Dottie, and thanks to Dave and Dave Collin, John Malarski, and Jordan Lindsay, and let's see, Shelly and Sabrina and Clay. Who else we got?
Well, we got Jay Berger, who's up, Linda Thomas, who's the Boeing engineering support, and then, of course, always the guys in the VR lab.
Yep.
And the MBL divers. There's a guy there named Mastracchio, I believe.
Better be. And thanks to everybody at MCC. Appreciate all the hard work today.
This is Naoko early in the day, up at Adam in the MPLM.
Yes, we have today and tomorrow, and then we will close the MPLM hut. So we were very busy to reconfigure the MPLM for return. So lots of piece of forms, we have to reconfigure for return, which is different location from the resupply. So we are working very hard to pack everything.
We shot a couple shots of video so people could see what these racks look like. That's a resupply rack. It has different stowage volumes for different bags. This this is a resupply platform, an RSP we call it, with different size bags, and there are several of those along each side, and they can also rotate. You can see one in the background there that's rotated out of the way so we can get behind it, because there are bags behind it as well. Anyway, MPLM looks great now. This was first thing in the morning, and now it's much, much better than that. Anyway, coming up out of the MPLM and making a return into the Columbus module, you can see that Soichi and Stephanie are inside working on one of the racks that we delivered.
Yes, this is a muscle atrophy resistive exercise science experiment, or MARES, which is the rack for the European Space Agency, and has a lot of foam to protect, of course, the sensitive components for the experiments. And one of the things that we're trying to do here is to take, reconfigure all of the parts so that we can take this foam home. The parts are, of course, very useful. The foam is not quite so useful on orbit. So we were able to get all of that stowed, and the module's nice and tidy now. Outside the airlock for it to open. Right now, Tracy and Jim are prepping Rick and Clay for EVA 3, and pretty soon they'll come out of the, they'll come out, we'll be able to get tools on and get them all ready, put their safer packs on, and then get them into the airlock. So TJ and I are waiting, and here you go, the hatch is opening.
That's Jim coming out, and Rick and I spend the night, so we camp out for the spacewalks, and that's to pre-breathe oxygen and help get the nitrogen out of our system so we won't get the bends in any of our spacewalks. And the EVAs were performed on the odd days, flight day 5, 7, and 9, mostly because I'm very odd. And we had a great time, and they pushed. This is Clay going in feet first, Rick goes in head first, and it's kind of a choreography to get everything inside the airlock, two huge spacesuits, and then all the gear that we need to take outside in order to do the tasks that we're going to do.
Yeah, we get a lot of good training at Johnson Space Center, and Jim was noting today that though he and I hadn't trained together on the ground, it seemed that our training was put to good work, good use inside the airlock.
This is Alexander getting one of his early workouts on the TVIS machine. And here's Steph and Jim at the robotics console.
Well, the robotics went really well again today. We got to go in and release the tank to Clay in the back of the payload bay before he and Rick bolted it down. And Stephanie did a great job of releasing that and getting back off the pin. It's pretty dynamic. When the guys are in the suits, they have a very hard time stabilizing in positions where the suit doesn't want to be because of the pressure inside of it. And Clay just did a really good job holding the tank still for us.
This is Oleg Kotov, the commander of the Soyuz and the International Space Station. He's doing some exercises on the new advanced resistive exercise device. And this is Soichi on the bike.
Yeah, I'm doing the CS workout, aerobiking at the speed of 70,000 miles per hour. It is fun, and all the kudos to the ISS. Thank you very much.
Naoko and I, Tracy in the MPLM, and a great nose set of Daddy Metcalf Lindenberger.
Yeah, this is one of the interesting things about being in space is that you can use the windows in new and inventive ways, and to look back at the station truss assembly from the pilot's window, you have to kind of get on your back and put your face up in the window, and it's really a beautiful view. This is a shot that we shot from the flight deck of the orbiter with one of our payload bay cameras, And this is the Gulf of Aden and the mouth of the Red Sea and the east coast of Africa. It's absolutely stunning contrast between the reds and browns of the sand and the bright blue waters. Really, really stunning views. And you can see the high contrast that you get there with the earth limb. And there's a shuttle KU antenna in view as well. Of Clay and I out EVA in the payload bay. This is where Steph and Jim are handing off the ATA, the ammonia tank, over to Clay, and then we were going to bolt it down to the truss segment in the back of the payload bay. This shot is from the cupola. You can see the great view the cupola provides, not only of the Earth, but here of the payload bay docked to the space station. You know, the ATA, we had some trouble with one of the bolts today, and we know that the engineers designed these devices to with very tight tolerances, and things just changed a little in space, and we realized that. And so we had a little bit of trouble getting one of the bolts to tighten up, but the ground helped us out, and they did a great job giving us some advice on releasing bolt 3, and once we did that, everything seemed to go real smoothly.
And as Jim mentioned earlier, Clay did a nice job holding the tank steady for us as we were backing the arm off. Again, it's a nice testament to the hard work of our EVA and robotics teams and trainers and mission designers for the great choreography that all of that work provided.
This is a picture of the camera Charlie or camera C on the orbiter taking a look at me working on the tank.
My job is to just watch everybody, and I was helping Dottie out with photo TV requirements, and helping keep track of all the small tasks that need to go on, and delivering food and coffee to those that wanted it. We've got such a hard-working team up here. They use me as a runner and to do the most miscellaneous tasks that everybody else can't get done because they're so busy doing the important work.
Great day for ICS 131. We accomplished 3 EVAs, and also for the transfer, we made the MPLM almost for the return configuration. So it is a wonderful day spending in space. And here is Elliot. He's also helping us lots of transfer today, and he knows a lot better on the International Space Station. So he is so experienced in packing and in strapping everything. So it is a great asset to have him on board. And sometimes you just have to make things fit. And as you can see here, Naoko is getting all the foam and bags into place. It was a real team effort to get everything locked down. And there she is, being Superwoman with Stephanie. Sometimes the cameraman just needs to watch out. But you can see floating in space is a lot of fun, and if you make your work fun, then it's no problem to do it. And I think that all of us could say, no matter how tedious tying foam down may be, it's really fun because you're floating. All I can say is that the STS-131 crew knows how to make foam fun. And there's Sweetie, who agrees wholeheartedly. He's taking a few lights from the MPLM so that we can have them on board here on the station for those rare occasions when the light goes out, just like our video.